Let's figure out what's going on in the supply chain industry in a little bit more detail. Our go-to guy in some respects, in many respects, is Mark Manduca, GXO Logistics Chief Investment Officer, joining us now on the line for more. Mark, let's talk about what is happening here. You obviously see this on a day-to-day basis. What is happening in terms of deliveries? What's happening in logistics? There are bottlenecks, it seems like. There are bottlenecks all over the place. How much of a mess is it?
Thank you, Guy. And I wouldn't be cancelling Christmas just yet. Christmas is definitely happening this year. It just may be happening in a different way across the supply chain. And obviously, as you'd expect, I would say, a company such as GXO is going to be well the solution to this problem, is my sense. So let's not confuse the short term and the long term here. Long term, I think that the North Star and final destination of everything that's happening and what that has happened with e-com is clearly not been derailed. On the more cyclical, seasonal and short-term front that you mentioned, this peak season that we're going into is still going to happen, as I mentioned, and I think customers are increasingly choosing to fulfill their orders via e-commerce channels, given the speed to market that e-commerce offers over other channels. I mean, it can be more like 2 to 6 weeks if you go through the traditional brick-and-mortar route. So peak is not cancelled. The flow of goods is simply changing, and we're the magic dust that's going to solve a lot of problems, we believe, over the Christmas period.
Magic dust. It sounds so poetic. So does that mean that I can still get whatever I need to get? I'm just going to either have to pay more or be more creative in where I'm looking?
We're going to see, I think, a shift towards a couple of things. In terms of our business, reverse logistics is clearly going to be an important part of helping the problem. If you think about how the market is shifting away from brick and mortar and more towards e-com, reverse logistics clearly allows you to get that inventory into the back of the store and to the front end to allow the customer to buy it again quickly. So an erudite beacon of hope such as us, a 3PL that can get that inventory back into the front store is clearly going to be in demand during this period. So the answer I have to you, Alix, is yes. Christmas is happening,
okay. And
you will get the goods.
Okay, just explain reverse logistics for a minute. I'm assuming this means all the stuff that turns up at my door that we want half of that we're returning.
Well, it's slightly worse than that. So in some cases it's half, in some cases it's more. Overall, 1 in 3 items are being returned versus, say, 20 years ago where the number was 1 in 10. So a lot of people are not only scratching their heads on the macro front, all the points that you made are well thought through, but also on the micro front, you're sending 1,000 T-shirts into a warehouse, and then 1,000 T-shirts are going out to the consumer, and then 300 are coming back. It's chaos. And you need a partner of choice in this new world, one that is technology proficient, to drive those savings for you and to drive that inventory management. That's why you need a 3PL guy.
It's funny. I ordered some items over the coronavirus shutdown period. Lamps, things like that, from one of the e-commerce sites, and they wouldn't take it back. They said, look, you can return it, we'll refund the money, but don't ship it back to us. Just do whatever you want with it because we don't want it in our warehouse, which was a little bananas. Hey, Mark, we were talking to Ravin Gandhi of GMM, and he said he saw price increases everywhere in his supply chain. He raised prices 10 to 25%. What are you seeing in terms of pricing?
Labor inflation is clearly an increasing problem, as you've mentioned, Alix, across the global market, and it's not just in the port of Los Angeles, as some people tend to focus on. It's obviously across both the East Coast and West Coast of the U.S. market. We're seeing it in the U.K. as well. And what I would say is that if you think about that macro point, inflation for us, I think, is here to stay, particularly given the various labor subsidy schemes that are still prevalent in the market. And at the micro level, if ever there was a moment for differentiation of employers of choice, I think now is the time. And obviously, we have a few open positions, and our goal is to win that race by hiring the best talent at great prices. So we're seeing very strong demand to work at our firm in what is effectively a very tough environment. I also think what will happen, and it's not just in 3PLs, I think that there'll be an added increase for tech. So not only is Christmas happening, I would say that robots are also saving Christmas along the way.
Excellent. Just put little white beards on them. Mark, in many ways, this started a while ago when the airline sector shut down and belly cargo disappeared. As the airlines come back online, how much of what is now being shipped by ship or truck goes back onto the airplane And how does that affect the kind of cascade effect back down through the supply chain?
I knew it was only a matter of time before we started talking about the airlines. And I think you made a really good point before the opener, which is this idea of hesitancy about bringing capacity back on. As you know, Guy, half of all the global air cargo capacity goes in the belly of a plane. So what's happened, obviously, is that the capacity has come down. There's been less space, and that means that freight rates have shot up on the air side. That means that people have cascaded their goods from air into sea. And naturally, with high demand, as I mentioned, for e-commerce, what you're left with is unsustainably high demand alongside extremely low supply. And if there is any hesitancy about bringing that passenger capacity, aka also belly capacity, back into the market, you're going to see those air freight rates at very high rates. In some cases, air freight rates can be 8x or 10x what you see in the container shipping space. So don't think that people will shift back from containers, as you say, to air freight as quickly as you're describing.